Hi, let's talk about situs inversus. Situs inversus is a congenital flipping on the horizontal axis of viscera. It may come in a variety where all of the viscera are flipped upon this horizontal axis, and that's known as situs inversus totalis, or it may just include either the thoracic or the abdominal organs. In total, situs inversus has about a 1 in 10,000 incidence in live birth, but typically it's associated with dextrocardia, and that would be the apex of the heart and most of the substance of the heart being to the right of the body rather than the left of the body. So we can see that having this apex there is very unusual. In this individual, we could also see that the liver, as well as the stomach that we can see here, is also rotated. In the individual over here, we don't have the superior portion, but we can see that the aorta is on the right side rather than the left side, and the liver is also here on the left side rather than the right side. So both of these are examples of situs inversus totalis. Now, up to about 1 in 5 individuals with situs inversus has something called primary ciliary dyskinesia. This is a defect in the structure of cilia that makes them rather immobile or not properly mobile, and so they're not able to have their normal ciliary motion. As a result of this, there's an impaired mucus elevator. So individuals with primary ciliary dyskinesia aren't as able to move mucus up the bronchial tree and conduct impurities out of their conductive portion of their airways. This can lead to chronic inflammation, which can then cause a dilation of the bronchial tree. This is a condition known as bronchiectasis, and this is usually one of the more serious conditions affecting individuals with situs inversus who have primary ciliary dyskinesia. They may also have chronic sinusitis, so sinus infections, and middle ear infections, so otitis media, impaired fertility, anywhere that cilia are important to the function of viscera or to physiology. Individuals with primary ciliary dyskinesia are going to be at a disadvantage. But for those who do not have primary ciliary dyskinesia, so that would be, you know, about 80% of individuals with situs inversus, they may go on to live completely typical lives without ever really knowing that they had this particular condition. It might be elucidated with medical imaging or during a physical, when, you know, the physician is auscultating the heart, and they go to listen to it at typical auscultation sites, and they're unable to, and then they start finding that better places are in atypical locations. But you know, aside from correlated diseases such as primary ciliary dyskinesia, there really isn't a detriment to situs inversus. Thank you very much for your time.